How to control a BLDC motor speed. Electric motors are used in many tools and vehicles. In electric aircrafts, they are most often controlled with a throttle controller and ESC. When you increase the throttle on your controller, what you're doing is increase the amount of electrical power drawn from your power supply, for example, your battery. And that is eventually fed to your motor via the ESC. But what's the science behind this mechanism? For the purpose of this video, we're going to assume that we are looking at a steady state condition where there is no acceleration. With that in mind, for a given mechanical load, controlling electric motor speed is as simple as controlling the amount of electrical power delivered to the motor. If we look at this equation for angular velocity, we see that the angular velocity, aka motor speed, is proportional to the voltage and negatively proportional to the torque. Therefore, if we want to increase the motor speed, we can either increase the voltage delivered or decrease the torque. Since decreasing the torque would require changing your design or load, it is much simpler to increase the voltage. The equation also demonstrates that at constant voltage, a higher torque results in a lower RPM. We should also note that there are some minor losses within the ESC, so the input voltage is higher than the average output voltage to the motor, but usually only by a few percent. In a no-load condition, you can also use the motor's KV value to estimate the motor speed based on the voltage delivered. We can replace the back EMF with input voltage in this equation to estimate the rotation speed of an electric motor. The risk with increasing the voltage too much is that the insulation on the magnet wire inside the motor could break, or the current could increase to such a point that the motor becomes too hot. As demonstrated, there are a few ways to control your motor speed. The most actionable way is to increase the voltage delivered to the motor by increasing the throttle. You can also decrease the torque, but this is generally more disruptive to the design or purpose of the UAV. If you found this video useful, we hope that you will subscribe. If you have any more questions about electric motors or how UAVs work, please check out our other videos or leave us a comment below.